Chances are, in your life, you've had the common cold before. The cold is extremely common. You know, it causes the sneezing and the coughing and just makes you feel awful. The worst thing about a cold is that you can take medications to help with the symptoms, but you really can't treat the actual cold. You can't really get rid of what causes it. Why is that? The reason for this is because most colds are caused by viruses. And we've talked before about antibiotics. They only work on bacteria. And viruses are definitely not bacteria. So antibiotics have no effect on viruses. In fact, viruses aren't even cells at all. You can't say a virus is a prokaryote or a eukaryote. It's not a cell. It doesn't have a cell membrane like all cells have. It doesn't have a lot of cell components. It's a non-living structure. In fact, viruses can't even reproduce on their own. So viruses, again, are not alive. It makes them very difficult to treat. But let's talk about what they actually have. What is their structure? Because they do have a structure. One thing all viruses have in common is that they have some type of genetic material. Now, this does not mean that they can reproduce on their own, but they're going to use the genetic material and force their host to reproduce themselves. This genetic material for some viruses is the form of DNA, and for other viruses, it's RNA. They also have some kind of protein coat, also known as a capsid. Capsid's a vocab word to think of. They can protect that DNA or RNA genetic material. Another thing to mention is that viruses are very, very small, much smaller than bacteria, and you typically are going to need an electron microscope in order to see a virus. Very, very small. Viruses can also contain other structures. Some of them package special enzymes with them. Some viruses have an outer envelope. So there's different varieties on what viruses can have, but the main thing is that they have genetic material and they typically have some type of protein coat, also known as a capsid. Now, viruses are very, very specific. So you want to think of them as they're pretty picky. Usually viruses have specific types of cells that they go after. So let's talk about viral reproduction, because we did mention that they can't reproduce on their own, and they're very, very specific for the host that they're going to go infect. So the first cycle of the two that we're going to talk about is the lytic cycle. In the lytic cycle, the virus, remember they're very selective, attaches to a host cell, and it's going to inject either its DNA or RNA, depending on what kind of genetic material it has, into the cell. You would think the cell would notice this, but in many cases, it does not. It takes that genetic material and it starts following the instructions, which in this case is very bad because what it does is it makes copies of the virus. And it starts making so many copies of the virus that usually it's going to cause the cell membrane of the host to rupture, explode, lyse. And so what happens is now these new viral copies, they get out of the cell and they go and infect other cells. This is very bad. This is known as the lytic cycle. By the way, the lysing of the cell membrane, that is a very bad thing for a cell. Cell cannot survive without its cell membrane. So definitely not a good thing for a cell. Now, the other cycle is called the lysogenic cycle. And I like to remember this is the longer word. So I like to think of this as the longer sneaky cycle. A lot of times when we're talking about this cycle, we're talking about a special kind of virus called a bacteriophage. It sounds very fancy, but what it means, it's a virus that goes after bacteria. Many cases, when you're talking about a lysogenic virus, this is what you're talking about. But these types of viruses that go through this cycle, they do kind of the same thing at the beginning. They inject their genetic material, but this time the genetic material stays hidden in the host DNA. And so what happens is when the host replicates, it also replicates the viral DNA. And eventually what can happen is it can be triggered to go into the lytic cycle, and then the virus can start being assembled, and then it can lyse out of the cell. But in the meantime, whenever it's during the lysogenic cycle, it's just hidden in there. It's kind of a sneaky type of thing. So as far as what triggers it to go into the lytic cycle, it can be a variety of things, and scientists are still doing a lot of studies with this. Sometimes we've noticed there are environmental triggers like UV radiation or chemical triggers, but it can cause now suddenly this virus to switch into the lytic cycle and come out. So going back to the cold, which again is typically caused by a virus, A lot of times it has to run its course, and your immune system will take care of it. But some viruses are extremely complicated, like HIV, the virus we had mentioned earlier that can lead to AIDS. That virus, its host that it goes after, are immune cells. And by going after immune cells, it makes you very vulnerable to other infections and diseases. In fact, someone who had HIV, the common cold could be a very detrimental thing to their health. So it's something that scientists really are researching to try to treat. And it's difficult to, because HIV is a virus that tends to mutate quickly. And so if the medications are very selective against one specific type of virus and the virus mutates, it makes it difficult to treat. So with our talk today about viruses, you might wonder, well, is there anything positive about viruses? Well, viruses do play a major role right now in gene therapy. It's a very big field right now that's really growing with research. So viruses do play a big role with that. Also, scientists are looking for ways to manipulate or engineer viruses. For example, there's a type of virus that goes after insects. It's called the nuclear polyhedrosis virus. Highly encourage you to look it up. Well, this virus is very selective. It goes after certain insects. But if it can be targeted to certain types of insects, the type, say, that eat your crops, the pest, then it can make a great form of a pesticide. Now, the only problem is whenever you add some kind of pesticide, whether chemical or viral, there can be major consequences in the ecosystem. And when we get to ecology, we will talk about that. So just something to think about. But viruses are a major component of scientific research right now. That's it for the Amoeba Sisters, and we remind you to stay curious.